Good afternoon, everyone. This is Pastor Kenny Lee coming to you with today's daily devotional. I hope that everyone is having a great Wednesday. It's the middle of the week. Hopefully, when you look at this, at whatever time of the day that might be, you will find the time to sit back, to listen deeply for God's voice in our time together, and to be challenged in your living. Before we read today's word, I want to invite you into a moment of prayer with me. God, we thank you for a time in which we can open ourselves more fully to you. We open our hearts to your word. We open our minds and tune our ears to your voice. We ask that through the power of your Holy Spirit, that this time would be a means of grace to us, that we would know your presence, that we would be challenged to live as faithful followers of Jesus Christ. For it's in his name we pray. Amen. Today's scripture passage is Ephesians 3, and I'll begin reading with verse 1. This is the reason that I, Paul, am a prisoner for Christ Jesus for the sake of you Gentiles. For surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given to me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I wrote above in a few words, a reading of which will enable you to perceive my understanding of the mystery of Christ. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humankind, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this gospel I have become a servant according to the gift of God's grace that was given to me by the working of his power. Although I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring to the Gentiles the news of the boundless riches of Christ, and to make everyone see what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things, so that through the church the wisdom of God in its rich variety might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. This was in accordance with the eternal purpose that he has carried out in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have access to God in boldness and confidence through faith in him. I pray therefore that you may not lose heart over my sufferings for you. They are your glory. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Paul, by his own admission, writes this from the cell of a prison, a prisoner for the cause of Jesus Christ. And Paul goes on to remind these Gentiles that he has been given a mission to be the missionary to the Gentile world. No longer is God's truth, God's covenant, God's word merely confined within the constraints of Orthodox Judaism, but now it is made available to the whole world through the work of Jesus Christ. Paul tells these Gentile peoples of God's love for them. Paul proclaims the gospel and tells of his own life journey. He bears witness to the work of God that was working in him, and the work of the gospel that is working through him, reaching out to people as he contacts them in his missionary journeys. Paul reminds him, this group of people who have gathered here in Ephesus to hear this letter read, that he has a mission, that his purpose is to spread the good news of the gospel. And in that reminder, we are all reminded as well that we too have a mission, and that is to spread the gospel of the good news of Jesus Christ. One of the best ways that any of us can do that is by telling other people what God is doing in our lives, by talking to people about our faith. Now, I'm not talking about getting a handful of pamphlets and dragging a soapbox out onto a corner and standing up with a bullhorn and accosting passersby with that in-your-face evangelism. That's an outdated model that is not ever really been effective in bringing people to a true understanding of faith. Faith is conveyed to people when they find themselves in times of crisis, when they're challenged with their health or a major occurrence in their life, like the birth of a child or the death of a loved one or the loss of a job. And it doesn't always have to be a negative thing. It can be a positive thing as well. But when we get to those points of crisis in our life and we start looking around to try to resolve the conflict, because all of us have a very hard time living in that level of conflict, we try to find a resolution, and oftentimes people turn toward God. And so it is left up to us as believers, as people who do follow Jesus Christ, to share our faith with other people. And that's what Paul has done with this church in Ephesus. And even from a prison cell, even in the most squalid conditions, in complete almost isolation with the exception of a few people that are allowed to see him, Paul continues to work to bring people to a deeper level of faith in Jesus Christ. Paul continues to work to write letters of encouragement to the church at Colossae, to the church in Ephesus. He reaches out with the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ, just as each of us do. And our life experience, the things that we have gone through in our life, the places where we have found our deepest levels of challenge, and when we found God showed up in a very unexpected way, those are the times and the places when we're most open to the gospel. It may not be the day that the preacher preaches a salvation message and the pianist plays what seems like an endless round of Just As I Am, as the song leader looks at the preacher for it to be okay for them to end and the benediction to be said. Those emotive moments can be times when we respond to the gospel, but they can also be times when people are put off. We need to be sensitive to the working of God's Spirit in us and in other people. I'll give you a for instance. On my way here to make this video today, I was tasked with stopping and picking up a piece of paperwork from another church member. And as I rolled up to their business, I decided that I was hungry and it was lunchtime, and I was going to go on past and then stop on the way back. But as I came up to the business and actually passed the first entrance, I felt really strongly impressed that I needed to stop. And so I turned in the second entrance and drove through the dusty yard and came in and got the paperwork and had a deep conversation about spiritual matters, about things that are going on in people's lives. And I realized pretty quickly that I had a divine appointment. We all, every day, have divine appointments. They may be small, they may be large, they may be significant, they may just be a little blip on the radar. But the truth is that God is seeking to work in us toward other people through us, and sometimes God has to even work in spite of us, like when I drove by the first entrance. But if we listen, if we're sensitive, if we take the time out of our day to have that conversation, it can make the difference in another human being's daily experience. It can be an opportunity for them to hear God speak to them. Saint Francis of Assisi was said to have instructed the people in his tutelage to preach the gospel and use words if necessary. Understand that it's not just what we say, but what people see us do. It's what we do when no one else is looking that matters the most, because that shows the reality of our integrity. It shows our faith commitment when what we do when no one is looking. I hope that this gives you an opportunity to pause and reflect, because As I look around our culture right now, as I look around our political landscape, and as I look around the COVID-scape that we are all having to live in right now, people are getting tired. People are anxious. People are worried. People are fearful. And yet, in all of that worry and anxiety and fear that every one of us deals with on a regular basis, God is still there. God's presence is not contingent on our circumstances. But perhaps from time to time, our circumstances create in us an unresolved conflict, something that we need to be open to God for the answer. Things that require divine intervention if we have any hope of that problem being resolved. I want to encourage you to listen deeply today, not just to this video, but to what God is saying to you. I want you to have your eyes open for those divine appointments. I want you to be sensitive in your heart to the Spirit's voice so that when you get that prompting to go and speak with someone or to stop, it may be an unexpected stop, but listen to what God is saying to you. Allow yourself to be a conduit for God's grace. I want to share with you today a song by the Afters. I do not own the rights to this song, but it is a beautiful contemporary worship song. I'll include the link to this song in the description of the video.
Every anxious thought that steals my breath, it's a heavy weight upon my chest. As I lie awake and wonder what the future will hold, help me to remember that you're in control. You're my courage when I worry in the dead of night. You're my strength 'cause I'm not strong enough to win this fight. You are greater than the battle raging. Trust you, Lord, I will fear no more. I will lift my eyes, I will lift my cares, lay them in your hands, I'll leave them there. When the wind and waves are coming, you shelter me, even though I'm in the
I hope that today you have heard from God, that a word has been spoken, that you've received a little encouragement, a little hope. God is ready to hear our prayers. God already knows the challenges that every one of us face today, and He's there with us and for us. Would you pray with me? God, we thank You for Your presence in our lives. We thank You for this time that we've shared together, which we've heard Your word, O God. We thank You for the power of Your Spirit that has prepared our hearts. We ask that the seed of Your word be sown deep within the fertile soil of our hearts, that our lives may blossom and bear fruit for Your kingdom. God, we ask You to lead us in the way that leads to life. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. I'm looking forward to seeing you guys all again tomorrow. Remember, like, share, subscribe, and follow Jesus. I will see you tomorrow.